I don't know how the weather feels where you guys are at, but right now where I'm living, it's like a cool 55 degrees and it feels like opening day, and I'm ready. It's not exactly opening day for us, but I'm ready for our next game. We're taking on the Heaters and Boris Bigsworth, who somehow has a zero ERA even though he's got terrible pitching stats. So let's go rope some homers off of him. So Holder Close is our starter today. He's got great junk and accuracy, but not a whole lot of heat. We noticed that last game, so I'll grab that one, Holder. Nice arm, and we got one out. We can use this junk and... Whoa, that's a terrible pitch. We're lucky that didn't get killed, but hopefully we can use this junk and accuracy to locate some pitches on the outside like that one. Sackliner just let that go through the infield, and there goes my perfect game. Another ball snuck through the infield, so now there are two on and only one out here for Holder Close in the first. Definitely not a perfect start to this game, but... Oh, that was a strike. Okay. Like I said, definitely not a perfect start to this game, but, you know, maybe we can get out of the jam and, you know, not allow any runs. That'll do it. Janice Freeman, Gaspar, Hicks, double play. Let's go bat. Hicks is leading off again. He's done a great job in the leadoff slot since we've put him there. He's gotten multiple multi-hit games. He's in a 3-0 count now. And that is strike one, but, you know, we're keeping the bat on the shoulder for those counts. As he's going to rip one in the left. He's on first again. Dude has been an on-base machine here so far in the season since we've put him there. As we put Chimo back in the two-hole, let's see if he can make the most of it. Chimo's going to hit one right back at the pitcher as he might reach. Not quite. Just not fast enough, but it does move Hicks over to second as here comes Wade Hobbs, who's... Oh, that was a line out? Man, I thought that was on the ground. He's going to line into the double play. Probably shouldn't have swung at the first pitch. Do get a little excited when he's at the plate because he's a freaking beast. Because there's Chimo throwing it over to first for another out. There's a strikeout for Holder Close. High inside fastball. Gets the man nut, or just gets the man looking. So he stood there frozen, and we get our first strikeout of the game. There's Freeman collecting one for out number three, and now we're up to hit again as it is Hackliner to start the second. Let's see. Whoa, I did not mean to swing at that one, but let's see if he can, you know, maybe get us a hit here. I don't think that's going to do it as he's going to be out at one. Ellaroids is going to put another one up the middle after Harmony Strew struck out. So I don't know why Ellaroids has been hitting so well. She doesn't have the greatest batting attributes, but we'll take it. As here's Friedman, who's been moved all the way down to the 7-hole after a bad performance in the 2-hole. That was a horrible swing. And now it's 0-1. It's another bad swing, 0-2. Come on, Friedman. Oh, what a catch there from Janice Friedman. I didn't think there was a prayer he'd get over to that one. Well, that was a really bad pitch by Holder Close. And that one's getting belted into the outfield. That's a single. Luckily, nobody, you know, moved there after the incredible play from Friedman. So let's see if Holder Close now can get out of the inning with one on. Oh, that's not good. Get it, Hobbs, or nah. So now two on and two outs here for Holder in the third. Hopefully, you know, we don't allow anything else in this inning. Definitely not trying to get down early or down at all. So we did make it out of the jam with no runs allowed as here comes Fungo Akuro now into hit. So he's going to dribble one back to the pitcher. And we have another out as I should probably stop swinging at the first pitch. So I struck out with the pitcher as I just now realized as he walked up to the plate and they said his name. His name isn't Hold Her Close. It is Holder Close. Not Close, Close. I thought he was since he's a, like, pitcher, his name was like Close. Like, you know, close the game. And Hold is also a relief pitching stat. No, it's Holder Close. I'm an idiot as I struck out with Darcy Hicks again. I don't know why I'm struggling to hit so much here in this game. In the bottom of the fourth now for the Wideloads, we lead off with Chimo Gaspar. Jeez Louise, I'm struggling at the plate right now. As a gamer, I don't know what the word there would be. What I'm really struggling here is let's hope we can get something with Hobbs. Hobbs is going to hit one down the line as that will be a single. We're not going to try for second again. We've learned our lesson there from previous episodes. As here comes Hackliner now with one on, one out. Come on, Hack. 2-2 to Hack. See if he can make something of it. As always, going to pop one up to the catcher. Get out of play. No. Gosh dang it. So now it's Harmony Streus. Let's see what she can do. 3-1 to Harmony. It's a hitter's pitch. And I didn't swing. God dang it. Jeez Louise. I cannot hit today. Well, I mean, I strike out a lot anyway, but I'm really struggling today. This pitcher's not even that good. Oh, there's a strikeout for Holder Close as he strikes out the nine-hole batter. Because that was our first time ever striking out a pinch hitter on three straight pitches. That was honestly probably our first ever strikeout on three straight pitches. As I'm surprised that one didn't just get belted. Usually if you miss anywhere, it gets destroyed. So that curveball is just a little low. Let's see if Holder Close can get him with that one. Nope, but Hicks is there to make the play over at first. Two outs in the inning. Elleroids is back up to start off the, or lead off the bottom of the fifth is Huck Unduck. Huck Unduck as their pitcher is, my God, I cannot hit the ball. Nice. Yep, that was a strike, I guess. Did not come in over the plate, but I don't know why, but these balls seem like they're coming in really, really fast. As he out, no freaking horrible contact there. And it's now up to Fungo Akira, who him being a B-plus rating is absolutely disgusting because this dude sucks. I know he's rattled, but he sucks. Yep, that one's not getting out of the yard, Fungo. Maybe if you weren't rattled. Oh, another strikeout there. Oh, please don't be a bad throw. God in heaven, Harmony. What is that? This dude's about to go all the way around on a strikeout. What was that? Come on, man. So we got two easy outs in the infield after that. So now we're looking to get another one here, maybe at the plate, as that would get us out of the inning. Maybe that can be the pitch. Chimo couldn't get there. Gosh dang it. Nice freaking job, Harmony. Holder Close is pitching an absolutely great game when you blow it with that god-awful throw into left that allows him to get three bases out of it. Wonderful job. Got our third out pretty easily, but now we are down one, as I think we're going to bring in a new hitter here for Holder Close. It's going to be Mashadonga. Easily our best bat off the bench. Oh my God, and she freaking grounded out on a horrible, on a pitch that should have been destroyed. It's a high curveball or slider, whatever it was. Should have been absolutely killed. Darcy Hicks is going to belt one into center, and guess what? It's going to get caught. So now two down, and Chimo's up. Into the seventh now, Wade Hobbs is our opening hitter. The reliever is locked in. Hopefully we can make that. How was that? Okay, whatever. I don't know how that wasn't killed. It didn't look like I was on top of it from my angle. Come on, Hack. We need a hit here, buddy. So yeah, that ball, like, this guy has less than 50 velocity. Please get out. Please exit the yard. God dang it, it's foul. This guy's less than 50 velocity, and the pitch is getting here in 0.75 seconds. That one wasn't too fast, but I don't know. Some of them look like they're coming in hot as finally we get a base hit. Haven't been able to. Every time I've made solid contact, it's gone right to somebody. Let's see if Harmony Streus can do something here with runners on. 3-1 to Harmony. Give me something here. That might be the one. Can Harmony Streus get it out? She can. Yes, Harmony. Harmony Streus. No homer since the first game, but she finally gets lucky number 4 here against the Heaters. It's a two-run shot to take the lead against the Heaters. Well, that a girl, Harmony, is, oh my God. Whoa, Der Never Walker. Yeah, no, yeah, definitely not going to walk anybody here. Jeez, who is this guy? Who is this guy? Where did he come from? I'd say he'll make an all-star appearance. Good God. Yeah, that was terrible, Janice. Probably should have gotten a little farther underneath it. Maybe I should have just let that guy pitch me 9 straight pitches and have 3 straight strikeouts just so we can, you know, get him to throw some pitches. We need that guy up and out of here as quickly as possible. Oh, Chimo. 2 on for Bowser here in the 8th. It is a high-pressure situation. As we get one there, piece of cake for Chimo. As we really need Bale to come through here. and not allow any runs, because I doubt that we will be scoring any more off of that absolute mammoth of a pitcher that they have. Now it's 3-0 to this guy. And we finally hit the zone with a strike. Can we maybe put another one in there? Oh, thank God it was foul. Oh, boy. That would have been very bad. Can Buzzer maybe get a strikeout? I don't see that like that. I don't understand. How did he just crush that? Outside screwball running away from him, and he crushes it. Was that opposite? I don't know if that was opposite direction or what. This guy's not a great hitter. We still only have one out. Maybe we can either get one at the plate here or turn two. Because that's pretty well best case scenario there. So we get an infield fly. What the heck? Chimo, throw it to first. We don't have anybody covering first. Yeah, that explains it. That explains why we... Nice, Darcy. I don't know if you can get a double play off an infield fly like that, but that guy was way off of first. We easily could have gotten him there, but, you know, whatever. There's another one lifted into center. Can Fungo Akuro get there? No. Gosh dang it. They're going to send another one home. And now it's 4-2. Come on, guys. That should have been caught. Bale's not even pitching that bad. Oh, my Lord. He's not pitching bad at all, actually. We just can't field. I'm not going to lie to you guys. Chimo Gaspar's fielding these past couple of games have really been unimpressive. Has really been unimpressive, too. So now we're back down to a two-run lead, and they're bringing in another absolute beast somewhere on the field, and Fungo Akuro is going to pop one up on a ball that, if I would have been an inch higher, would have been absolutely destroyed. We have one out here, as I think we got to sub out Bale Bozer. Try to get somebody else in here with some batting. It's going to be Olaf Bjerson again, Mr. Tie the game in the ninth himself. Jeez Louise, that ball looks like it's coming in at about 110 as Bjerson just destroys one to the third baseman. And now it's back up to Darcy Hicks. Let's see what he can do. This dude just threw one 100 at me, and now he's... I don't understand. It's just too fast. I was on that and everything. There's just no way to hit it. It's too fast. So I guess we'll bring in Molly Pops to pitch here in the top of the ninth. But if that dude stays in, I don't think there's a chance in hell that we get another run. Because like I said, I mean, he's throwing 100-mile-per-hour fastballs at me. And I can't hit one that goes in the, like, mid-90s, so... You gotta be kidding me. Oh my gosh, that scared me. Alright, one down. Chimo, look at that. Another one where he just drops it on the diving plays. Obviously a diving play is not easy, but I don't think he's gotten a diving one here in the past couple games. So that one's another one that's going to be a very loud out to center. If we can even get underneath it. Yep, Fungo's got it, but my Lord. Molly Pops has given up some absolute what would have been bombs if they would have been anywhere else in the field. So this one should be an easy one for Hack. Get the out at first, and now we need two runs here in the bottom of the ninth to keep the game alive. We've got a good part of the lineup to try to do that. We're facing a guy with dang near 99 everything across the pitching board. God dang it, Chimo. He is struggling at the plate big time. That ball should have been crushed. Let's see what Hobbs can do. I just got to make sure I don't swing at the first pitch if it's bad. I've had a bad habit of doing that with him these last couple games. Inside curveball, I hit it. Goes right to the third base, and we're down to our final out. Those are the ones I just really don't understand in this game. Hackliner is our last out. Gosh dang. This is a strikeout for sure. Maybe not. Hackliner, that a boy. All right, keeping the inning alive. Because he threw me a curveball. And, I can hit breaking pitches pretty well. As now it's Harmony Struess. Pretty sure she struck out to lose a game not too long ago, and she's tense. 1-0 to Struess. Come on, Harmony. 1-1 to Struess. 1-2 to Struess. This might be the ball game. No, Harmony belts one to center. I don't know if it can get out. It's going to go off the wall. We're going to bring Hack home, and we're going to put Harmony at second. Get there, Hack. All right, 4-3, and it's Ella Royds coming up with a chance to win the game at, or at least tie here. Let's see what she can do. Jesus. Elleroids is going to hit one into center. It is high and it's deep, but I don't think it's far enough. It's not. Man, that, I mean, oh my God, why is the center field fence 432 feet back there? That's kind of ridiculous. I hit a home run 360 earlier. Are you kidding me? 432 feet, huh? Wow, that's disappointing. I mean, like I see, you send that anywhere else in the park, that thing's gone. I mean, ball goes 420. That should be a homer. Like, that's ridiculous. We lose this game on a just because we were on a giant field. That's perfect. So now we're 4-4, third in our division. Can we look at the season standings here? I don't know how many teams make the playoffs, but and we just lost to the worst team in our division. But if they started today, my guess would be that we would not make it. So geez, Louise, that is rough. That is rough. Let's take a look at some of the league leaders now. In batting, Wade Hobbs is the fifth best batting average, or third best batting average. Hackliner sixth. Homers, we got a lot of guys out there. Hobbs leads the league. Harmony Struce and Chima both with four. Hackliner has three. RBIs is also Wade Hobbs. Right now, if he gets up there in average, he'd win the triple crown. Chima, Harmony Struce, and Elleroids are all up there in RBIs. On base percentage, Hobbs and Hack. Slugging, Hobbs, Chima, Hack, and Gaspar. On base and slugging, there's another one. For hits, total hits, Wade Hobbs is tied with Hackman of the Moonstars for first. Hackliner is up there. Chimo's up there. Extra base hits. Chimo leads the league in extra base hits. Hobbs has eight. Hack seven. Struce seven. We have nobody in the strikeout category. Thank God. Runs scored. We have nobody with any stolen bases because we don't try to steal bases because we have no speed. As Latoya Lumberg is up there and wins. We know we obviously don't have anybody with three. We don't have anybody in the ERA category as I don't even know who Lucy Finnegan's play for. She doesn't even have a team up there on the third ERA person. And we don't have anybody with any saves, whip, opponent batting average, strikeout, walks per nine. Yeah, we don't walk too many people. But, yeah, that was a quick look at the lineups. We will probably do our lineup a little different here for the next game. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe if you want to see more Super Mega Baseball. Hopefully we can get a win in the next video. We've lost these last couple games due to some just absolutely stellar pitching that I have no clue how to hit off of. But like I said, I will see all of you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.